In this lesson, we will see how we can implement JWT tokens in order to protect a certain route. I've already created the code and I'm going to explain it here. Basically, first we have a one packet JSON file where we are using the following libraries: bcrypt, cookie parser, express, and JSON web token. And then we have included type module in order to be able to write proper ECMAScript 6 inside of our Node.js application. Here is a server. Started with node index.js file, and it's listening on port 3000, which is basically this function here. So let's see how it works. First, we are importing all the libraries mentioned. We have two functions, create token and authentication middleware, in another file, which is our helper file. So first, we are creating our application. We are configuring the express in order to be able to use and parse JSON requests. And also, we are using cookie parser as middleware. We'll examine our login route. Its goal is to check our username and password and to form a token which will be sent as a HTTP only cookie. So first we are grabbing our body and we are destructuring from it the username and the password fields. To simplify the lesson, I've created one user which has ID, name and password, and this is an object, and I am comparing whether the user.name, so this my user, is the same as what we have from the request. And if it's not, we are sending a JSON request that this is the wrong username or password to the user. We continue when we have something in the user, and we are comparing whatever the user has sent with the request body with what we have inside of our simplified database object. We're comparing it using bcrypt because actually this is an encrypted variant of this world here, a secret password. So we are grabbing whatever comes from the input, we are encrypting it, and we are comparing it with this long string here, because if someone goes ahead and somehow hacks our database, they will be able to see just encrypted values. So that's why we are storing the passwords in such form. So when our comparison completes and we have a match, we can compose our access token. In other cases, we are just sending a forbidden status of the request to the user with a wrong username and password. Now to the formation of the access token, we're using this create token for helper function, which we'll explain in a moment. And when we have the token, we are sending it an HTTP only cookie in order not to be modifiable by the client, thus protecting against certain token manipulation tactics. Of course, you need to know that for full protection, you should use on top of this creation of access tokens, cross-site request forgery techniques, which again involves sending secret token to the client and then comparing it on each request. For this, I can recommend the CSERF library, and you can see it here in NPM, how to install it and how to use it, depending on the front end you have. As you can see here, we are using the library CSERF, and the moment we are rendering a form, we are generating a token, and we are sending to the view this token, so that the form will be rendered together with the token. And the moment the user clicks on the submit button of the form, we'll be entering the process URL, activating the cross-site request forgery protection, which will check the submitted token from the form with the generated from the server token. And if they are matching, this means that the client request is genuine and will be able to proceed with the data. Okay, that was for the additional protection. Now back to the code. Let's see our token creation and validation utility. We are using additional library JSON web token for the verification and signing of the tokens. In order to create token, we are just passing non-sensitive information such as the user ID in an object, and we are signing it with a special constant secret, which you can generate by creating something random or using some special characters. And with this secret, we will sign actually the sensitive information that will create the token that later we are using inside of the index.html and sending this access token as a cookie. Okay, and then let's see the authentication middleware. Here we are checking the access token received from the cookie, and if there is not such, we are sending request 401 with the message of error that the user is not authorized. And then we are trying to verify using the external JSON Web Token library the received from the cookie token together with using again of our secret, and if it's valid, we are basically going to the next middleware by using return next. And also here I've decided to set another variable authenticated to true, which helps when we would like afterwards to check whether our request is authenticated or not. And in case of our verification middleware returns an error or raise an exception, we are again sending a forbidden to the client. Now let's go ahead and try to test the code. Okay, here I'm using the client Insomnia, which is similar to Postman, and will be trying to go to the login URL with the post method, and will be sending applications of type JSON, and those parameters are username my user, and for the password, let's change the password to another one and try to send this to our login middleware. We'll click on send and we see wrong username or password as error, and here the status is bad request. But if we mention the right password and click again on send, we'll see that we are logged in and this is the okay response. And also what's interesting is that inside of the cookie we have our access token sent. We can try accessing our secret information URL. And keep in mind that if I click on send, we'll see that the secret info is displayed because we are passing through the middleware. So that was our goal. If we click on manage cookies, we see our cookie here and we can edit it, something that you cannot do directly from the browser because the cookie is sent via HTTP only. Let's try to change something inside of the cookie. Okay, and we click on done. And done again. Let's try again to send the request, and we see that we are not able to access our protected URL. So with this, we have shown how to use in practice JSON Web Tokens. Keep in mind to further protect your cookies against such manipulation by using anti-cross-site request forgery techniques. Okay, guys, let's see how we can implement programmatically cross-site request forgery protection inside of a Node.js application. So we're using a special library, CSERF. As you can see from the NPM page of the project, it's Node.js protection middleware. We need to install it with the npm install CSERF. Okay, so we are importing the library and then we are setting a special middleware by initializing CSERF from the imported library. The protection works either by using sessions or with cookies. Here we have chosen to use cookies, so the protection is stateless. This means that in our server will not have a persistent data. We are setting the cookie not to be modifiable by the client and not to be read by other clients except in the same domain, with the option HTTP only set to true. And then when it's set, I'm applying this protection to all the routes with op.all. So every request will pass through this protection middleware. Traditionally, the cross-site request forgery protection works by setting one session inside of the server and a special encoded token, which is then sent to the client. And with each request, the client sends the token to the server. And for the established session, is checked this token, whether it's the same between the client and the server. But we're using here the cookie method. And for this, we are required to send two cookies. So the first cookie will be sent through our protection middleware, and the second cookie we are sending using this response.cookie, where again we're using our library CSERF in order to generate another token, and then actually this will be read by our client, this cookie, and will be sent with each of our requests. What's the goal of the second cookie? Here is a short description of the double submit cookie technique if you want to read further, but basically the second produced cookie and sent back to the client is based on the first one. So even if someone resides on the same domain or subdomain and manages to read this cookie, they cannot change it, because the moment this happens, the hashed value of this token will change and the whole protection will stop the intruder. Okay, so let's construct one request towards our server. So we have a function that reads the cookie, and this is our request. So basically, we're sending a post request towards the URL of secret info, and here this is protected. If we send the information without our token, we will not be able to return a response of success, and we are sending color of green. And also, while we are making the post request, we are sending the cookie received from the server, then we are displaying the result to the user. While forming the fetch request, we are using cookie and we are sending it via the headers of the request. We can also append it to the body using the spread operator. Okay, let's see how this works. We'll start the server here and it's listening on port 3000. Now in the browser, we have two URLs. One of them is a local web server listening on port 5500 and it just displays the index.html file. Let's run the request and see that we have a forbidden status response to the secret info URL. We are receiving the first HTTP only cookie, but we are not sending the second cookie, so it cannot be verified by the server and the request is blocked. This is because the index.html page is not generated by our server. Now we have the server generated index.html page because we are requesting it on port 3000, just as our residing server here listens on port 3000, and with the function express static public, it serves everything that's in the public directory, which is our index.html file. Now let's try to run this request to see what will happen. And inside of the network, we'll see that our index.html is loaded, and afterwards we make a request towards the secret info URL and it has a status code of 200 OK. In the response, we see success. This means that our request has passed successfully. Let's see now the cookies. Okay, so this is our first cookie that the server sends to us, and on each request we are sending back. For the second cookie, we are getting it directly again from the server's cookie and we are sending it in our post request, as here we have programmatically done this in the headers. And that's why our request succeeds and we are able to see the success response here from the server. Basically, that's how you can protect your forms or information from this popular cross-site request forgery attack.